Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about PN junction diode, its construction and how the depletion layer is formed in the PN junction. Okay, so let us first discuss construction of the PN junction diode, right? So let us first discuss the construction of PN junction. As we know, the PN junction consists of P-type material and N-type material. The P-type material consists of large number of positive charges and very small number of negative charges, whereas the N-type material consists of large number of negative charges and very small number of positive charges. Okay, so in the construction of PN junction, we are having the P-type material and a N-type material. This is P-type material, this is a N-type material. Okay, so as we know, the P-type material consists of the holes as a majority charge carrier. So suppose here we are having the large number of the holes present in the P-type material. It consists of very large number of positive charges. And a small number of negative charges are present in the P-type material. So suppose a small number of negative charges are present in the P-type material. Okay, so next, whereas the N-type material consists of large number of negative charges, so we are having very large number of negative charges present in the N-type material. And the N-type material consists of very small number of positive charges. Okay, so this is the PN junction. Okay, why it is known as PN junction? Because it consists of P-type material, it consists of N-type material, and in between these two, here we are having the junction. Okay, here we are having the junction. Okay, of the two layers. So that's why it is known as the PN junction. Okay, so now we are having the two different materials. At one side, large number of positive charge carriers are there and very small number of negative charge carriers are there. At the second side, large number of negative charge carriers are there and very small number of positive charge carriers are there. Okay, so can we say that the density of positive charges in the P-type material is very, very high? What do you mean by the density? Density is nothing but the number of charges, right, divided by the volume of that layer. Okay, so if we want to find the density of the positive charges in the P-type layer, okay, then we can say that the number of positive charges which are present in the P-type layer or the P-type material divided by what is the total volume of that P-type material or the total area of the P-type material, we can see. Okay, so that will give you the density. Okay, so here we can write the P-type material consists of large number of positive charges. So density of positive charges in P-type material is greater than density of positive charges in N-type material. Okay, so the density of positive charges here is greater than that of the density of positive charges here. Okay. Similarly, can we write the density of negative charges in the p type is less than the density of negative charges in the n type. Okay, so we can write density of negative charges in p type, density of negative charges in p type is less than density of negative charges in n type, is less than density of negative charges in n type material. Okay, so here we are having the density of positive charges more here, density of positive charges very less here, density of negative charges very less here, density of negative charges very high here. Okay, so these are the materials we are having, and now we are connecting these two materials. Okay, so what will happen? As soon as these two materials are connected together, as soon as these two metals are connected together, so what will happen? As here we are having the large number of positive charges and here we are having the very small number of positive charges, so what will happen? The positive charges from p type material will try to cross the junction and will try to move towards the n type material. Okay, so from here to here the positive charges will be moving from p to the n type material. Okay, similarly here the density of negative charges is high and the density of negative charges in the p type material is very very less. Okay, so as soon as these two layers are connected together, the negative charges from n type will try to cross the junction and will try to enter into the p type material. Are you getting the point? Okay, so here negative charges will be moving from n type to p type and the positive charges will be moving from p type to n type. Suppose this positive charge will enter into the n type material. Okay, so first of all, this positive charge, where, at which position, at which place this positive charge will occupy its place? Yes, definitely this positive charge will, after crossing the junction, this positive charge will accumulate the space at this position only or near to the junction only. Okay, means whatever the positive charges are moving, right, from p type to the n type, these positive charges will try to accumulate the space, will try to place at the layer which is present or at the space which is available near to the junction. Similarly, when the negative charges are coming from n type to p type, these negative charges will try to occupy the space, will try to occupy the place near to the junction only. Okay, so if you check, after connection of the p type and n type material, we'll be having one type of the layer near to the junction, right? So once p type and n type materials are connected together, here suppose this is p type, n type, at the p side we are having a layer of negative charges which is formed near to the junction, and at n type we will be having a layer of positive charges which is formed near to the junction. So this is the layer which is present near to the junction. Okay, so as soon as we connect the p type and n type material, okay, then what will happen? Here we will be having a one layer near to the junction, and that layer is known as the depletion layer. That layer is known as the depletion layer. Okay, of course here in the p type we will be having the large number of positive charges as it is, but some positive charges will move from p type to the n type and they will occupy the space near to the junction, right? So similarly, here we are having the small number of negative charges that will be present. Okay, next, here large number of negative charges as it is. Okay, and small number of positive charges. Right? Are you getting the point? Okay, why this depletion layer is formed? Because we have connected the two layers, we have connected the two materials. One is a p type, second one is a n type. In the p type we are having the large number of positive charges and very small number of negative charges. In the n type we are having the large number of negative charges and very small number of positive charges. So as soon as these two layers are connected together, definitely the positive charges from p type will try to move towards the n type, and the negative charges from n type will try to move towards the p type. Okay, but after moving or after movement, yes, these charges will occupy the space near to the junction only, and it will cause the formation of one layer near to the junction. Okay, and that layer is known as the depletion layer. This layer is known as depletion layer. Are you getting the point? Okay, so this is the depletion layer. Are you getting the point? Okay, so suppose if we go into the market and if we purchase the diode, okay, by default in that diode there will be, yes, the existence of the depletion layer. Okay, for the formation of depletion layer, whether we have applied the any external source, we have connected the any external source across the diode, no. As soon as we connect the p-type and n-type materials together, definitely there will be the formation of the depletion layer, and this depletion layer will play a very important role in order to understand the turning on of a p-n junction. Are you getting the point? Okay, so this is about the basic construction of the p-n junction and how the depletion layer is formed. Okay, now the symbol of the p-n junction, symbol of a p-n junction. This is the symbol of p-n junction, anode, cathode. Okay, so this is the symbol of p-n junction. Okay, p-type material is represented with the anode terminal, n-type is connected to the cathode terminal actually. Okay, and in between we are having the p-type and n-type material and the depletion layer also. Okay, in the next video we will discuss about the biasing of p-n junction. Thank you.